Nier Automata is an action RPG that was initially released on February the 23rd, 2017 on the PlayStation 4, with a PC release 3 weeks later. The game tells the story of Androids 2B, 9S and A2 in their battle to reclaim the machine-driven dystopian Earth overrun by machines. This is a full-price game costing £39.99 on Steam, and I'm going into it from the point of view of someone that's never played the previous Nier game. So this is Nier Automata, a game that was initially released on the PlayStation 4. It's now came to PC, and I'm incredibly excited to try it out because it does look really cool. This video is a little bit delayed because I've had some audio issues, but hopefully we're going to be all good from now on. Oh, okay. One of our friends have got zapped from something. Quite an interesting perspective we're starting out with this game, I have to say. Right, so now I can move. I guess I need to dodge the laser beam. My friends aren't doing too well. Oh, I can shoot now. And, okay. Very interesting start to the game. Oh, okay, so I wasn't in a plane. This is some kind of suit. Oh, okay. This is a little bit awkward to control. Oh, my friend's dead. Lovely. Everyone's dead. I'm the only one alive. Of course I am. So straight away, right out of the gate, this game has very interesting uses of camera. Oh god, I guess I need to dodge all of these things. Oh, this is very claustrophobic. Really cool so far though. Okay, and now we're going to a sideways camera. One awesome start to the game. Lots of things to dodge. Okay, I got a level up. I'm now level 2. My suit has like a sword. If I press heavy attack, that is fucking cool. So this is my character, I guess. Activating some badass female. Y is a heavy attack and X seems to be a normal attack. I'm guessing there's going to be some kind of combo system. Certainly seems that way. But the movement and the controls right off the bat feel very smooth and responsive. Right trigger makes me kind of move really fast, like a dodge ability almost. Apparently there's a giant factory saw-like monster attacking me.
Is that our target?
If I press left trigger, my robot locks on, so that's handy. Let's dodge, 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 dodge. Oh, let's dodge. Okay, nice dodging skills, Craig. Fantastic. Let's go. Big damage with the sword. Beautiful. There it is. Alright, we've got a little friend, I guess. And that's level 3. It's cool. I like these mechs that everyone's flying around in. Shoot it, little robot friend. Alright, this is no problem for me. I can just jump over all of this. And then chop them all up. The game's hardly even started, and something that's just majorly standing out for me is this game's use of camera. It goes from being a 2D side-scroller, to a top-down game, to a third-person game. It's crazy. Gives you a real feel of variety. Oh, okay, we got flying units now. Nice! I used my robot's little zappy ability. And now we've got a top-down ARPG perspective. It's really useful in dodging these things, though. I'm bloody useless at this game. I'm constantly getting hit. I hope that's normal. Can I do my zap ability? Yes. Yes, I can. Basically, don't give the AI a chance to respond by being very fast with your attacks and unpredictable. That's the idea I'm getting with the game so far. I can't even imagine how hard this is, though, on the highest difficulty. Because right now, I'm on normal mode. Apparently, on hard mode, if you get hit once, that's it. You're dead. How hard must that be? If this isn't a boss fight area, I don't know what is. It's either going to be the end of the level or a boss fight. The cutscenes don't seem to have the best frame rate. They seem a little bit lower than actual in-game frame rate. Not too sure what's up with that. I'm not too sure why this robot thing's pissed off with me. But what can you do? Oh god, how am I going to avoid this one? I'm dead! I'm dead. I'm fucking dead. Ah. I am actually hopeless at this game. It's a hard game, I can say that. Right, how am I going to avoid this one? I guess we just dodge through the middle? No, too hard for me. Dodge! Okay, we actually avoided one for once. Like, yeah, the frame rate in some of these scenes is bloody awful. Maybe it's something to do with the PC port. I had a feeling there was going to be something more to fight. It's a giant robot factory monster. And it's bloody huge. This is how you start a game. You give us a fucking awesome giant boss fight. It's using both of its arms. Okay, yeah, okay. That was hard to avoid. Okay. Okay, monster, let me bloody dodge. Medium recovery used. That's not good. Oh my god, this is hard. Oh my god. Oh my god. I've got to avoid all the balls. Ooh, how does one avoid that? Right, okay. Balls everywhere. Right, so it's destroying the bridge. Okay, I actually avoided an attack. Good for me. Oh, did he just sacrifice himself for me? I think so. Right, we need to go and save our friend. So we're now fighting on the boss. Is he alright? Oh, the guy's a robot. Maybe my character's a robot as well. We've known each other for 5 minutes and my character's already emotionally involved. She didn't really give a shit when all of her friends died at the start. Now we're dealing some bloody damage to it. Right, okay. Oh my god, look at all of the balls I need to dodge. Okay, so now we have stolen the enemy's arm. And we're gonna hit him with his own arm. Oh my god, this is cool. Wow, dude. You just die already. I think we killed it. So after you've done the intro section with the boss fight and everything to the game, you're given some actual backstory and context to what's going on. So I can talk to 9S and change my combat style. Balanced, close range, long range, aggressive, cautious, passive, or unchanged. I think I just want to go with balanced because I'm not really too sure on my playstyle yet. This is cool, I'm controlling both of them and we're in some kind of spaceship above the Earth. So to save game, there's no autosave or anything. You need to find an in-game means of saving game, like one of these access points. So I guess we're on our way back down to Earth. Left bumper is missile barrage. That's cool! I like that ability. Okay, this actually feels like a bit of an open world segment. Can I kill these animals? Get back here. I can kill the animals. Grab some food for me and 2B. Not that androids tend to eat much, but... So all of the humans on Earth have been wiped out. But these animals are absolutely fine. Alright then. So if I use the pause menu, I've got a 3D map of the area and I can zoom in and out. Okay, you can fish in this game apparently. So, let's do some fishing. Oh, I use my robot friend to fish. We actually caught a fish. That's really cool. So this is the resistance camp, actual humans. Well, mostly. Because I'm terrible at this game, I'm going to buy 30 medium recoveries. You can also buy buffs, which increase your melee and ranged damage, as well as defense. Right, let's help him out as well. We'll take these side quests, and we'll see what we can get for him. So we've got two little side quests we need to be cracking on with now. Oh, wow, that is one big, big pig. I'm going to have to kill it. Oh, okay, maybe not. This pig's not fucking around. Oh, wow, this is a big monster. This is a big machine. What level's this one? Level 25. Well, I guess I'm not supposed to go to that area yet. When your character dies, it remains on the map as a corpse. I need to go and get the data back from my body. Right, now we need to run. Now we need to bloody run. Let's not fuck with that robot. Wow, I can just glide to the floor with the help of my robot. There we go, we'll execute the robot. It's pretty damn cool. So, when you knock down enemies, you can do like an execution ability. Oh no! She survived jumping off of that. Okay, I'm obviously gonna go for the coolest looking sword. And this one might just be it. Beast Lord, it's called. Something definitely worth mentioning with this game is that the music is absolutely stunning. It gives me old Final Fantasy game vibes. Right, so now I'm gonna test out my new sword. It deals so much damage. It really fucks up these monsters. It pretty much one-hits them. Oh, cool, you can slide down the sand. I like that. Who the fuck wants to live in a desert house? Not me. So since playing the game, something I've learned about it is when the monster's eyes light up and a little sound happens, that's when you should dodge. And you basically combo really well if you dodge at the right time. So what we're going to do is we're going to wait. Then we're going to dodge. And as you can see, my person kind of does some kind of iframe. It seems as though you do a lot more damage after successfully dodging. Oh my god. That was a lot of dodging. And that was a lot of fun. The combat in this game is bloody glorious. Once you figure out how the dodging works, it becomes extremely fun. Oh my god, there's a giant one now. The camera work in this game is fantastic. Even when fighting a giant enemy like this, the camera just automatically adjusts so I can actually see what the hell's going on. The robots are trying to have sex with each other, look. What is this? This robot's trying to get the other one pregnant. That is so fucking weird and confusing. I can hardly see what's going on. I'm just mostly trying to react to the robot's red little attacks. Because I can hear when they're about to attack. There's so many! What's going on? Now they're going insane. What is going on? The robots just gave birth to a machine humanoid thing. Right, so now this is going to be a real boss fight. The more we attack it, the more it levels up. It has no genitals. Let's just run away. Oh god, it knows my movements almost. Heal. Oh my god, he's powerful. Big damage. Big damage. We're slowly getting him down. I do not want to die against this guy. Finish! There it is. Level 9. And I think we got him. Bloody hell. It had blood, and it's supposed to be a machine. Oh my god, I'm so confused. It's a healthy baby boy. I just got an achievement. We've got a bed we can use. There's two of us. I wonder how this is going to work. Do you want to take a break? So this guy's just going to stand there and watch me sleep, is he? Yes. Yeah. That's exactly what he's gonna do. Right, I think this is where I need to be. Or not. Maybe. What's this? A new weapon? Oh, nice! I just found a new weapon! That's cool. It's like Robot Disneyland. Amusement park. Interesting. Now we're fighting clown robots. I feel like I'm improving at this game slowly but surely. When you play it for the first time, extremely hard and a bit confusing to get used to. Oh, I know. I can just platform up here and then I can jump over the fence or something. Oh, a little boss, clown machine. Oh, he's actually a friend. He's not even attacking me back. I'm such a dick. We've got to fight a carnival tank thing. Okay, that's not good. Dude, dodge, 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 dodge. Get outplayed, tank. Get outplayed, Mr. Tank. Okay, we're currently getting absolutely fucked by Mr. Tank right now. It's a little bit of a clusterfuck. Actually, we're doing all right now. Finish. I think we got it. I think we got it. There it is. This is a really cool part of the game. Oh, incoming motion sickness. Oh, nice. Of course we're going to have a fight whilst riding on this thing. Oh, it's got like human corpses attached to its dress. Why is a robot wearing a dress? Oh god, there's going to be a lot to dodge here. Oh, wow. The mechanics are really cool. Oh, no. Oh, I should have jumped up. What is it doing? The boss fights in this game are bloody awesome. Let's dodge, jump up, going for the attacks. Now we've got a top-down segment. Wow, this is bloody crazy. What are you doing, monster? Begin hacking? The fuck do I do here? So there's a mini game here where I need to hack things. Robot corpses. What on earth is going on? This has got to be one of the most original and unique games I've ever played. This is up there with some of the Dark Souls fights. It's fucking crazy good. Let's just go in with some big damage here. Big damage. Big damage. Oh, it's taking so much damage. Let's go. Let's go. Let's cut her up. Let's finish her. Biggest of damage. Oh god, it's turning into a crab monster. Oh, hacking. We're good. Back into the action. Dodge. Oh no. Oh, we're good. We dodged it. We dodged that one as well. Jump up. Dodge. Nice dodges. This is so intense. No! Oh my god, I'm so close to being dead. No! I fucking died right at the end. Okay, we got a level. Oh no! Is my character okay? She's limping. Right, ultimate attack. I think we killed it. Bloody good boss fight. One of the best boss fights I think I've ever experienced. The music in this game throughout so far has just been fantastic. Very fitting, very epic. The story in this game is really intriguing. It seems like the robots have actual emotion. This robot wants me to go to their village. I absolutely fucking love this game. It's an absolute masterpiece from what I've played of it so far. It's so original, so interesting, and the gameplay is just so good. I like this game so much that I think I'm actually going to buy it on PlayStation 4 as well. So this is the robot village and they're all waving white flags. Ah, friends. So right now I feel as though I've got a decent enough first impressions of Nier Automata. I obviously don't want to play it too much, as it may give too many spoilers in this video for those of you that haven't played it. So as always with this series, we're now just going to wrap up this video with a summary of my thoughts on the game so far. So at this point, I feel as though it's really obvious that I enjoyed my time with Nier Automata. This was the first Nier game that I've ever played, and going into it, I didn't really know what to expect. But right from the outset, the game grabs you by the balls, and it's immediately fun, action-packed, and gives you a good idea of what's to come. In terms of gameplay, the combat feels smooth, fast-paced, and fluid, always keeping you on your toes. And due to the camera constantly changing from a third-person to 2D side-scroller or top-down, the game feels like it has a lot of variety, and I can't really see myself getting bored with this one. The more I played this game, the more intrigued I was with what it was going to throw at me next, and that's a really cool feeling. Another thing certainly worth mentioning is the audio. I've personally really enjoyed the music and soundtrack in this game so far. I feel as though it's made boss fights feel that extra bit more epic, and the actual in-game sound effects adds an extra layer of impact to the combat. I've also found the voice acting to be really good so far too. Lots of emotion and lots of character. Another thing I feel as though the game's done a really great job with is sucking me into the story. As someone that's never played a Nier game before, I was a little bit worried going into this that I'd be a little bit lost with the story, but honestly, I feel as though you can just jump into it as a completely new player. Everything's explained, and honestly, the further you get into it, the more intriguing it feels, and the story's just starting to feel as though it's getting really good for me. Usually when I do these end of video summaries, I like to have some positives and negatives, and honestly, I'm struggling to think of many negatives with this game so far, so I'm gonna have to nitpick. It's a little bit annoying that the PC version of this game doesn't have a windowed borderless mode, although it's not really a big issue because there's plenty of programs to force it to windowed borderless, but regardless, it would be nice if that was a thing. And the only other thing that kind of bothered me were the in-game cutscenes, as they really seem to struggle with performance, often dropping down to 20 or even 15 frames per second. I'm not too sure if this is an issue with the PC port or what, but hopefully there's a fix. But other than that, I can confidently recommend Nier Automata as a game you should definitely go out and buy, as it's one of the most unique games I've ever played, and it kept me entertained from the start of this recording all the way to the end. end, and I can't wait to finish the game and see how it all pans out. But that's it for this video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. I'm really sorry that my upload schedule has been so fucked recently. This has been due to a mixture of audio issues and personal issues, but most of it's sorted now, so hopefully we're going to be good for a while. As always, I'd love to hear your thoughts on Nier Automata in the comments below. I hope you all have a fantastic day. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again really soon.